Are you curious about the benefits of doing mental math? Or maybe you're a student or a parent or a teacher and you know someone who's asked you, what's the point of doing mental math? And as a tutor, I get asked this all the time. So in this video, you're gonna find out. Hi, I'm Janice and you're watching Sharp Cookie. For all the best studying, learning, and test-taking advice, please subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every week when I post a new video. On this channel, you always get real tips from a real tutor. So today's topic is on mental math. And this is something that I encourage all my students to do. And I even go so far as not letting them take out their calculators during my tutoring sessions, which you can imagine goes pretty well. This is what I tell them when they ask me why it's important. And first I give a really quick analogy because sometimes it's just easier to understand something through an analogy than spelling out the benefits. So let's say the student that I'm speaking to is really into soccer. I might say something like, oh, for years you've been practicing this skill, right, of kicking the ball, of getting goals, of heading, and you're getting better and better, and maybe you put a lot of money into it or your parents have so that you could be on traveling teams and you could get special equipment and you could pay fees for tournaments, et cetera, et cetera. And I'm like, you're probably never going to become a professional soccer player. And they would generally agree with me and say, yeah, you're right. I'm not going to be a professional soccer player. And then I'll say, well, then what's the point? Why do you even do it, right? If you're not going to make a career out of it, what's the point of getting better and better at a skill that, you know, when are you going to use heading and kicking in your career? And they might say, well, that's not why I do it. I do it because I want to be with my friends, or I like being outside, or I get physically fit. It's fun. There's all sorts of reasons. And I agree with you. There's so many reasons to play a sport or an instrument that have nothing to do with actually becoming a professional at whatever that is. That's not the goal. So, for example, if you're a soccer player, you also develop communication skills. You develop how to work together on a team. You also develop strategic thinking because you have to think about, oh, if my teammate's over here on the field, I need to be over there. These are all skills that then you can transfer to other parts and areas of your life and your future career. So this is what I tell them about mental math. It's the same principle. The goal is not, oh, I need a solution. The goal is training your mind to think and problem solve in a certain way and building those muscles through the process of mental math. Because if you just wanted to find an answer, or if you just wanted to make money or have a career, there's a lot easier ways to go about it, right? So there's an easier way to have a career than trying to be a professional soccer player. And there's a lot easier ways to solve a problem than using mental math. You can use your calculator and it takes no effort at all. But we want the effort. Through effort, we improve. Before I go into all the benefits that I've seen in my own students and myself, because I practice what I preach, and this is one of the ways I train my own mind so that I become a better teacher, I want to know, what do you think about mental math? Have you noticed any changes in your life? Or maybe you just avoid it? Let me know in the comments. I would love to hear about it. Benefit number one, increased focus and concentration. So mental math takes effort for our brain. It's like going to the gym. You can lift a 1 pound weight or you can lift a 50 pound weight. A 1 pound weight is your calculator, okay? It takes almost no effort. But if you're using mental math, this is exercise for your brain, specifically in focus and concentration. You can't get distracted because then you won't remember what step in the math problem you're at. So especially in today's day and age when everybody is on cell phones and electronic devices and our attention spans are getting smaller and smaller, this is a skill that's so important. Or maybe you or someone you know has ADHD or has trouble focusing. You can actually improve your ability to focus by practicing it. It's just like any other skill. You can improve your memory by focusing on exercises that improve memory, and you can improve focus and concentration by forcing yourself to solve things that require focus and concentration. Benefit number two, self-confidence. Now, this is one that some people roll their eyes at or think it's a little cheesy, but I promise you, I have seen dramatic improvements in people's self-confidence and self-esteem when they start doing mental math. And the reason is a lot of people have math anxiety, or they have old stories in their mind of how they're not good at math and how they're dumb at math and they don't understand numbers. So when they start to learn mental math, it completely changes their attitude around these stories that they've built up for years, a lot of times. Some of us are adults watching this and you totally get it. You know what I'm saying? You have a whole story playing that you're not good at math. Well, if you do these exercises and you get better at it, you completely change that story and it improves your confidence, not only with math and numbers, but in other areas of your life. Every time we accomplish something that we never thought we could do, it transforms the way we see ourselves. So once we have this story that I can't do this and we overcome it, our confidence goes through the roof. Benefit number three, mental math improves our ability to think and reason sequentially. Now, what does this mean? This is a cognitive skill where our brain thinks in logical steps. In other words, A has to be done first before I do B. So this ability for sequential reasoning happens when we need to organize something or plan for an event or even plan our day. Maybe you have to run errands and you have to think about what route you can take and where should I start and where do I want to end up. These are all things that we use sequential reasoning for. And when you do mental math, most of the time the problem has to follow certain steps and you can't reverse them. But of course, if you do it on a calculator, none of that happens. The calculator does the steps for you. So I'll give you an example. In my other video where I talked about dividing any number by 10 or 5, in order to divide by 5, it's actually two steps. You have to first divide by 10 and then multiply by 2. So your brain has to break things up into chunks and steps, which is really, really good for the sequential reasoning skill. So mental math helps you get better at planning and organizing. Benefit number four, mental math stimulates both sides of your brain at the same time. This is so important. This is even more important for kids where their brains are still developing. You want connections between both hemispheres of the brain. So when you're solving a math problem, the calculating part is done on the left side of the brain. And then the part of your brain that needs to visualize the problem being solved is the right side. Now, if you're using a calculator, if you're writing the problem out by hand, you lose the piece of having to visualize in your mind what's happening. Now, if you're a visual learner, you're probably going to really like this. And you might be someone who already enjoys mental math like I do, and I'm a visual learner, because this tends to be a natural strength. But if you're not a visual learner, you can actually improve this skill by doing more mental math. And now the last benefit, benefit number five, mental math improves working memory. Now, working memory is a very specific type. There's short-term memory, long-term memory, and we have working memory. Working memory is what we use as we're solving a problem. So I like to compare it to the RAM in your computer. So as you increase the RAM, you can have more applications and programs running at once, and everything just runs smoother and faster. And it's the same thing with your working memory. When you have to do mental math, you have to remember all the steps, and you have to remember the solutions to every step in order to apply it to the next step. So in the beginning, a lot of people have trouble remembering all the numbers from each step. By the time they get to step three, they forgot what the number was from step two. But if you start with mental math that's shorter and easier, and then improve over time, just like my weightlifting example, You will build this skill over time. You'll be surprised how fast you will be able to do multi-step problems because your working memory will improve. It's like getting a better laptop. Okay, so that's it for today. Those are just five of the benefits of mental math. And just to summarize, the whole point of doing mental math is not to just get an answer, because we know there are easier ways to get an answer. The point is the skills that you develop in your brain to get to an answer are things that make mental math important. So who doesn't want more focus, concentration, memory, self-confidence? All of these things can then be applied to other areas of your life. Have you enjoyed this video and you want to continue the discussion with me and with others who are interested in the same things you are? Think about joining the Sharp Cookie Community Facebook group. I'm going to leave the link below. You can find it. Come join us. And the second thing I want to mention is I do offer one-on-one virtual tutoring. So if this is something you're interested in, please shoot me an email at hellosharpcookie@gmail.com. And now that you know all the benefits of mental math, you can get started practicing right away. So check out my videos. I give you some quick, easy skills and practice sessions you can do at home. Have you found this video helpful? If you have, please give me a thumbs up, give it a like, and I know to make more content on these types of topics. Also, make sure to subscribe. I provide new information on studying, learning, and test taking every week in a new video. So I would love to welcome you into the Sharp Cookie community. That's all I have for today. This is Janice. Take care. Bye.